Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. In this video, we'll see what is Nonia and how to use it for automating your networking task. Nonia is an automation framework written in Python. The advantage with Nonia is the framework is 100% Python, and that means if you know Python, you'll be able to troubleshoot most of the issues in Nonia. Most of the other automation framework hide their languages, and it'll be hard when you want to handle some advanced use cases or advanced troubleshooting, but using Nonia, you will be able to troubleshoot using Python. So here you can see one sample script which they have given. In the end of this video, we'll execute this and see how to use Nonia. So now we'll go to tutorials. Here you can see as Nonia allows you to use pure Python code, you can troubleshoot and debug it in the same way as you would do with any other Python code. Here you can see Nonia lets you automate your environment by providing you an interface which does a lot of heavy lifting. So using Nonia, you will be able to leverage other well-known Python libraries such as Netmiko, Napalm, etc. In the previous screen, you can see the script. It uses Napalm get, and it uses here in the example, it uses facts and interfaces. You can see multiple get methods available in Napalm. Using this one line of command, you will be able to get any get, you'll be able to use any get method from Napalm. Now we'll go to how much Python do you need to know. Yeah, here. So in order to use Nonia, you have to know some Python. Here you can see you don't have to be a master. As long as you know the very basics, you will be able to use Nonia. The Python skills required is set up Python on your system. These things I have covered in the initial videos of this series. Set up Python on Linux, then install virtual environment and Python packages using pip, then basics of Python, variables, functions, imports. Those things, if you want to see, you can watch the initial videos. Now to install Python, the command is pip install Nonia. So we'll install it. I'm already into my virtual environment p3.6, and the version required for Nonia to run is 3.6. The recommended version is 3.6. pip install Nonia. Yeah, so you can see the libraries which it installed. So in the next part, you can see initializing Nonia. So you need to have a configuration file for Nonia to run. If you don't have configuration file, it will fetch the values default. You can see it uses YAML based inventory. Here in configuration file, it is mapping to three files. Number of workers means number of thread it can run, concurrent sessions. We will see this in detail in upcoming videos. Now we will try to execute that sample script which is provided in the home page. I'll copy the script. Here I have in my Python folder 05 Python demo, I have a folder Nonia, and I already have all the supporting files here, and I have created a file 01 Nonia intro. I'll paste it here, and here the configuration file name is nonia.yaml in the example, but in my case the file name is 01_config.yaml. You can see number of workers is 100 and my host file is 01_host, and it is in same location, and I have a group file and defaults. If you want to see the content of this, I have three files here, three devices here. Host 6742, it is a Cisco router, and 47 as well as Cisco router. 6730 is Arista switch, and it is mapped to one group, Cisco group and Arista group. And under group file, you can see a value platform iOS, and under default, I have username and password. In defaults file, the values whichever you're not defining in host and group, you can add it in defaults. If you're using a common password, you can define it in defaults file. Now we will edit the file accordingly. I'll give the file name as 01_config.yaml, and you can see here it is using the task napalm get, and it is getting facts and interfaces using napalm. If you want to see that here, you can see the get methods here, get facts. It is supported by iOS and EOS. Get facts and get environment. The platform details you can see here on top, the supported metrics here. Driver name is EOS, and if you're using Nexus, you need to give NXOS. So I'll try to execute the script now. I'll go to Narnia folder, Python. Yeah, I'm getting the output from devices. You can see here 6742, and its host name, and this the facts details, and this is my interface details for another router as well. I got the output, and this is from Arista device. Now if you want to get additional outputs, what we can do, we can just add it in this list. I'll add two more entries here. I'll give environment and interfaces IP. We'll verify that here. Environment and interfaces IP. I'll save the script. We'll try to execute again. Yeah. Now you can see I got interfaces IPs as well and environment for all the devices. So this is how you can leverage the library napalm using Narnia, and your code will look very simple. Now we'll see the inventory file details. We'll see which file is mandatory for executing the script. First we'll remove all the configuration and inventory file from this folder. So what I'll do, I'll create a folder and I'll move to that location all the file. Now we will try to execute the script. Yeah, we are getting the error saying that no such file or directory, because in my script I have defined configuration file as 01 config.yaml. I'll comment that line and I'll execute. Now if we don't give any configuration file, it will fetch the default properties. And now you can see by default it look for the file host.yaml. So what I'll do, I'll copy the current host file and I'll rename to host.yaml. They will try to execute again. Now the error what we are getting is key error, because in my host file there is a group and now I don't have any group file here. So what we can do, since we don't have group file, we will get the data from that, we'll put it into the host file and we will get the data from event defaults username and password. I can copy and paste same into my router 2 as well. In Arista switch, only the platform will change to EOS. I'll save the script. And here you can see now I have only one host file and I have added all the values to the single file. Now we'll try to execute the script again. Yeah, we got the same output. That means host.yaml is a mandatory file, but when you scale your network and when you want to do a lot of filtering and grouping, it would be always better to use it as mentioned here. In the upcoming videos, we'll see the details of inventory, connections, tasks, plugins, etc. in Nordia. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.